Good morning, everyone. It gives me immense pleasure in welcoming you all for the lecture video session. As you know that I'll be covering the module 3 in Elements of Mechanical Engineering, basically emphasizing on internal combustion engines followed by refrigeration and air conditioning. In the earlier videos, I could successfully cover and complete the theoretical aspects followed by analytical idea on internal combustion engines. Now I'll be concentrating on refrigeration and air conditioning. In my previous lecture video, I could cover the introduction pertaining to only refrigeration. What is the basic idea of refrigeration? A brief historical perspective, then the components in a typical refrigeration system, the terms associated with refrigeration system. If you wish to know the analytical idea pertaining to refrigeration, the technical terms associated with refrigeration are very important. We could learn a refrigeration effect or refrigerating effect. Next, coefficient of performance, relative coefficient of performance, ton of refrigeration, or what particularly we call it as refrigeration capacity. So those terms are very vital in understanding the detailed analytical aspects. In this lecture video, I'll be concentrating on the classification of refrigeration. Before that, one has to clearly understand the course learning objectives. Understand the concepts of boilers, turbines, pumps, internal combustion engines and refrigeration. So in the earlier modules, boilers, turbines and pumps shall be discussed. But in this, we are strongly highlighting on refrigeration. In the beginning of refrigeration, when we were learning introduction to refrigeration, I was clearly keen to mention the functionality of an ideal refrigeration system. But I could name the different components in a refrigeration system. Here, before knowing the classification of refrigeration, one should be very keen about the parts of a refrigerator. This particular slide will help to know the different components of a refrigerator. What are all the components? What are the functionality of that? How exactly these components help in the smooth functioning of refrigerator? Those things we shall learn. Fundamentally speaking, the parts of a refrigerator include evaporator, compressor, condenser, and eventually expansion valve or throttle valve. Along with these components, we find few other components that help in the configuration of a refrigerator, but these four are very prevalent. We shall try to know the functional features of this and the range of temperature wherein this will be responsible in the effective functioning of a refrigerator. To begin with, we shall take up evaporator. Normally, in any refrigeration system, it is the starting component. Some refrigeration connoisseurs or experts will even refer evaporator at the heart. So anyhow, for a human being, how heart is very important. For a refrigerator, evaporator is very, very important. Usually, in a refrigeration system, we find a storage tank wherein we prefer a refrigerant. As said in the beginning, refrigerator comprises a refrigerant. A refrigerant is a thermofluid medium wherein it continuously circulates in a refrigeration system and responsible for effective heat extraction. Without a refrigerant, the heat extraction in a refrigeration system will not happen. To begin with evaporator, whatever amount of refrigerant stored in a storage tank of a refrigerator, when the refrigerator is switched on, the refrigerant from the tank approaches an evaporator. In an evaporator, heat is continuously supplied. This is even referred to as a freezing compartment. We find evaporator coils in this. So when we take up the discussion about the classification of a refrigeration system, then in detail we will be knowing the information. In an evaporator, remember, due to the continuous heat extraction, the pressure and temperature of the refrigerant increases. Initially, the temperature of the refrigerant will be normal, but once after continuous evaporation, we can even perceive high latent heat of evaporation. The pressure and temperature of the refrigerant will augment. Initially, the form of refrigerant shall be liquid. On evaporation and other thermodynamic processes, liquid shall be converted into vapor. On evaporation or vaporization, next the refrigerant will approach a compressor. Even compressor is the most critical component in a refrigerator. All components are equally important, but without the dependency on evaporator and compressor, the cycle will not be complete. So, from evaporator, when the refrigerant approaches compressor, compression process takes place. As everyone is aware of the information on compression, the pressure and temperature of the vapor refrigerant is increased. Initially in the evaporator, the temperature and pressure of the liquid refrigerant will increase, but after compression, unquestionably, liquid refrigerant will be converted into vapor. Now, on completing successful compression process, the refrigerant now approaches condenser. Condenser is one of the components wherein responsible for artificial cooling. Refrigeration, as said in the beginning, it is a mode for attaining artificial cooling. One such component responsible for attaining artificial cooling process is, no doubt, condenser. During condensation, heat is rejected. Please remember that in evaporator heat is added, but in a condenser heat is rejected. But remember always, condenser temperature will be more than evaporator temperature. On achieving condensation process perpetually, finally the refrigerant will approach the expansion or throttle valve. In the expansion valve, due to expansion, the form of refrigerant is converted. Initially, it was liquid. Later, it was into vapor. Now, on completing the thermodynamic processes successfully, the vapor refrigerant will be retrieved back to liquid refrigerant. So, these four components will unquestionably configure a refrigerator. Therefore, evaporator, compressor, condenser, and finally expansion valve. They are the four pillars responsible for accomplishing the action of refrigeration. Remember that always compressor temperature dominates. Next comes condenser temperature. Next, evaporator temperature. Lastly, the temperature during expansion. The expansion valve achieves the lowest possible temperature. If we understand these thermodynamic aspects in knowing the parts of a refrigerator with its function, definitely the classification and description part will not be a big difficult task. So, on knowing the components of a refrigerator, we shall now peep to types of refrigerators. Academically speaking, normally we take up two. One is the vapor compression refrigerator, the other is vapor absorption refrigerator. In addition to this, we take up air refrigeration system, cascade refrigeration system, electroflux refrigeration system, thermoelectric refrigeration, magnetic refrigeration, and many other cryocoolers. But in the course elements of mechanical engineering, we principally concentrate on vapor compression refrigerator and vapor absorption refrigerator. It is a time to know the theoretical description of vapor compression refrigerator and vapor absorption refrigerator. This is the schematic of vapor compression refrigerator. Any layman or a common man will be in a position to understand the principle of operation of this refrigeration system. Let us know the information at the surface level so that anybody will be in a position to comprehend the aspects clearly and lucidly. What exactly this vapor compression refrigerator? What are all the principal components in a VCR? How exactly is that working? We should know the theoretical detail. As said just now, the principal components in a refrigerator are four: evaporator, compressor, condenser, and finally expansion device. In this schematic, one can clearly understand the components in a vapor compression refrigerator. Before knowing the principle of operation of a refrigerator, we should know why specifically this vapor compression refrigerator. The name compression clearly emphasizes that compressor is the most vital component. Compressor is regarded as the heart of this refrigeration system. That is why thermodynamically or professionally this is emphasized as vapor compression refrigerator, or in short the abbreviated form is VCR. Sometimes in the examination they may ask, with an aid sketch explain the mechanism of VCR. The student should not be in the state of pandemonium. VCR is vapor compression refrigerator. Let us know the information clearly. We need to begin with evaporator. In the schematic, we can see to the evaporator coils incorporated. This is regarded as the freezing compartment. Evaporator is also colloquially referred to as freezer coil. Freezing process is strongly focused. Whatever refrigerant we prefer in this refrigerator, it undergoes evaporation or vaporization in the beginning, wherein the refrigerant will have high latent heat of vaporization. Because of this thermodynamic constraint, whatever refrigerant used, that will be passed to the hermetically sealed compressor. Initially, the form of refrigerant shall be liquid. Later, On achieving a compression, we can perceive the vapor refrigerant to be formed. By seeing to the arrangement, the design of an evaporator, we can clearly understand the design and thermodynamic considerations. It will have metal tubing wherein the process of cooling will take place continuously. Because of this judicious action, the conversion from liquid into vapor happens in a compressor. On compressed, whatever vapor refrigerant obtained that possess high pressure followed by temperature, that form of refrigerant will be passed to condenser. In this schematic, one can clearly see to the coils of the condenser, condenser coils or cooling coils. The name process of artificial cooling shall be focused mainly depending on the action of condenser. Remember that in an evaporator, process of heat addition takes place, but in the condenser or during condensation, heat rejection takes place. Very few minutes ago, I clearly mentioned that condenser temperature should be higher than evaporator temperature. Because of this fact, heat rejected will be more than the magnitude of heat added. Let me take a simple thermodynamic consideration here. When the theory of heat engines is emphasized, when we just refer to the previous segment, what we learned, internal combustion engines, there I mentioned a term, thermodynamic efficiency or thermal efficiency. Thermal efficiency is basically the ratio of work done by the engine to heat supplied during combustion. How basically we calculate work done by an engine? It is the difference between heat added and heat rejected. Why? Because during heat addition, the temperature will be more, and during heat rejection, temperature will be low. But here, in the case of refrigeration, please remember that the work done by a refrigerator will be the difference between heat rejected and heat added. That is why when we wish to define coefficient of performance or performance assessment factor, the ratio of heat extracted to work done will be the coefficient of performance. It can be below 1 or above 1 depending on the type of refrigerator we choose. We were speaking about the process of condensation. On condensation, the refrigerant will approach eventually the expansion device. Expansion device, expander, are also professionally referred to as throttle valve. There, because of expansion, the least possible temperature is attained. Finally, whatever refrigerant expanded, whatever form of refrigerant expanded, that will get back to evaporator. This is how a perfect thermodynamic cycle is established in the process of refrigeration. Remember that when we go to the information in depth, preferably speaking in engineering thermodynamics while teaching refrigeration, there is a particular reason for calling this refrigeration system as vapor compression refrigeration. When we calculate the work done by this refrigeration system, we normally take that as work done by the compressor minus work done by the expander. Generally, heat rejected minus heat added will be work done, but professionally, when we go for the thermodynamic calculations, W compressor minus W expander will fetch you the magnitude of work done by the refrigeration system, particularly vapor compression refrigeration. But work done by the expander will be zero. Why? Because when we draw the temperature entropy plot or pressure enthalpy plot, clearly the enthalpy values during expansion will be the same. The process of compression process of condensation, process of expansion, and eventually process of evaporation, these four thermodynamic processes will be represented in a TS plot and pressure enthalpy plot. Please remember, work done during expansion will be zero. That is why normally when we calculate coefficient of performance, work done by the compressor should be considered. It is mandatory. The work done by expander is zero, since the enthalpy values during expansion will be equal. If they are equal, then naturally when we take the difference between the enthalpy values, work done by an expander will be zero. Generally, in any case of refrigeration system, W compressor minus W expander, that will be the basic form. But in vapor compression refrigeration, please remember that work done by the compressor is accentuated, but work done by the expander is zero. That is why very technically, thermodynamically and professionally, this type of refrigeration system is vapor compression refrigeration. I think each and every part representing this schematic have been discussed. When we know the information very comprehensively, we can understand even the practical aspects and concepts with ease. This is what the action of a vapor compression refrigeration system. So this was first ever invented or conceived in 1805 by Sir Oliver Evans. Sir Oliver Evans is regarded as the father of refrigeration systems. On knowing this VCR, next it is the time to know about vapor absorption refrigeration. In Elements of Mechanical Engineering, fundamentally we need to discuss on vapor compression followed by vapor absorption refrigeration system. When we spoke about vapor compression refrigeration, I could tell each and every point meticulously. But one question shall be raised by the viewers. What particular refrigerant shall be used or can be employed in a vapor compression refrigeration system? Very basically, we prefer Freon 12, dichloro, difluoromethane. So that is the chemical name for Freon 12. Freon 12 is the form of refrigerant what we prefer in vapor compression refrigeration. That is what the basic information one has to be clearly be aware of. Now, it is the time to know about vapor absorption refrigeration. Before I start, one should be clearly aware that are there terms like absorption and adsorption? One is the physical phenomenon, the other is the chemical phenomenon. When we take up normal refrigeration systems, what we are learning now, we follow absorption system. But when we speak of cryogenic engineering or advanced form of refrigeration system, we refer adsorption. At this juncture, we are not bothered about adsorption, cryocooler. We are bothered about the basic refrigeration system, vapor absorption refrigeration. What is the principle of this? What is the exact mechanism? What is the uniqueness? How vapor absorption refrigeration is unique when compared to vapor compression refrigeration? Those detailed one should be clearly aware of. As usual, when we take up ideal vapor absorption refrigeration system, VAR, the first component is evaporator. As usual, whichever refrigerant we prefer, it will undergo vaporization or evaporation and then comes to the next component. Remember, in vapor compression refrigeration system, we prefer Freon 12. But in case of vapor absorption refrigeration, we take up ammonia. Ammonia is a refrigerant what we normally prefer in the case of vapor absorption refrigeration system. So, initially when refrigerant absorbs or when it is evaporated in the fundamental component evaporator, then it comes to the next component called not compressor, it is absorber. Please remember, in vapor compression refrigerator, compressor is the heart. But in the case of vapor absorption refrigeration, absorber is the heart. In case of vapor compression, mechanical energy is utilized alone. But in the case of vapor absorption refrigeration system, solely we depend on thermal or heat energy. Therefore, whatever refrigerant initially vaporized, it comes to absorber. Next, as usual, we take up condenser expansion device. The other components remain the same, but here vapor absorption refrigeration absorber is emphasized. But practically speaking, when we depend on the principle of working of vapor absorption refrigeration, we even take up some of the components like heat exchanger, rectifier, analyzer. Why? Because the action of thermodynamics should be strongly emphasized in vapor absorption refrigeration. But since we are learning VAR, vapor absorption refrigeration, to the surface level, this schematic will help any common person to understand in a very simple way. Friends, as I said in the beginning, ammonia is a refrigerant used. Initially, we cannot expect high intensity or strong ammonia to be formed. Because of the use of circulation pump in the system, vapor absorption refrigeration system, the weak ammonia solution shall be converted into strong ammonia solution. Based on that, the process of circulation takes place. Some of the components, whatever employed in vapor absorption system, definitely help in the smooth action of vapor absorption refrigeration system. So this is what the theoretical detail, what one has to be aware of. With a neat sketch, explain the mechanism of either vapor compression refrigeration system or vapor absorption refrigeration system. This is a very commonly asked question in the semester and examination or continuous internal evaluation. Now, on knowing the mechanism of VCR and VAR, the last exercise what we need to take up before knowing the principle of operation of air conditioning, we shall make a comparative study between VCR and VAR. There are many points we need to take up to make the differences between VCR and VAR. This slide will help you to take up the first particular or parameter, that is utilization of energy. When we take up this parameter for vapor compression refrigeration system, as I said in the beginning, solely mechanical energy is used. But in case of vapor absorption refrigeration system, it is thermal or heat energy. The next aspect is coefficient of performance. This is very, very important when compared to all other parameters. Please remember that in case of vapor compression refrigeration system, coefficient of performance or performance assessment parameter is high when compared to vapor absorption refrigeration system. This alone will clearly substantiate that vapor compression refrigeration is more effective when compared to VAR. We have few other aspects wherein we can take up the comparison. When we take up the capacity, refrigeration capacity, in case of vapor compression refrigeration system, the ice can be produced up to 1000 tons of refrigeration. But when we take up vapor absorption refrigeration, definitely it can exceed 1000 tons. Next, coming to a very vital aspect. You know that in a vapor compression refrigeration system, compressor is the heart. Because of the continuous running of vapor compression refrigeration system, compressor produces loud noise. Because of loud noise, severe vibration problems arise. Therefore, the noise and vibration level in the case of VCR is high when compared to vapor absorption refrigeration. So, because of this running of compressor, noise problems will eventuate. Next, when we come to maintenance and operating cost, vapor compression refrigeration system have the vital factor. Maintaining cost and operating costs are high when compared to vapor absorption refrigeration system. Two more aspects we shall take up so that we can get utmost clarity in enumerating the differences between vapor compression and vapor absorption refrigeration systems. Penultimately, we can take up the issue of leakage. In case of VCR, because of loud noise, continuous running of VCR system, leakage problems arise. But in VR, it will be free. In VCR, we will be using Freon 12 as a refrigerant, but in a vapor absorption refrigeration system, we take up ammonia. Lastly, when we discuss about the overall functionality or the overall effectiveness of the system, industrially speaking, vapor absorption refrigeration will be useful. But in domestic application, vapor compression refrigeration is the key. So, on knowing the classification, next, the theoretical description of VCR and VAR, finally, when we learn the differences between vapor compression and vapor absorption refrigeration system, majority of the topics shall be comprehended. Lastly, when we wish to summarize whatever information we have learnt in this particular video lecture, we should just recap the course outcomes. Initially, we could know the fundamental parts in a refrigerator: evaporator, compressor, condenser, and lastly expander. These are the four pillars in a refrigeration system. Next, when we take up the types of refrigerators academically, particularly in this course Elements of Mechanical Engineering, we depend on the mechanism of vapor compression and vapor absorption refrigeration systems. Finally, when we enumerate the differences between VCR and VAR, you will get utmost clarity in knowing the refrigeration system. In the next lecture video, I will be discussing briefly about the importance of refrigerants, the types of refrigerants, and what are all the prerequisites or what are all the desirable properties of a good refrigerant. By that, we will be successfully completing the module refrigeration. This is all I was willing to convey. Thank you. Thank you very much.